A beautiful dive is like a great stage performance with three acts. A beginning, a middle, and an end. In these short dramas, the diver is an actor with a story to tell. For Kent Ferguson, the play has most resembled a tragedy worthy of Shakespeare. In both the 1984 and 88 U.S. Olympic trials, he placed a disappointing third, twice missing the Olympic team by one place.
I can just remember getting out of the pool after my last dive at several Olympic trials and looking up at the board and seeing myself third place, top two made the team. So an incredible sense of frustration has been carried with me for the last 8 years.
You get nothing for being an alternate. You don't go to the Olympic Games. You don't get to go to a training camp. You don't get a bathing suit. You don't get anything.
Through it all, Kent Ferguson didn't quit. After the 1988 trials, he put off dental school so he could continue diving. Then, competing at the World Championships in Perth, Australia, Ferguson won his first major international competition with a near-perfect final dive. Entering this year's Olympic trials, Ferguson was determined there would be no repeat of 84 and 88. He was third after the preliminary dives, but like a world champion, fought his way into second place and a spot on the U.S. team. But if Ferguson's style is graceful and refined, his U.S. teammate and rival is all rough edges. Mark Lenzi is the aggressive newcomer to the sport of diving, now in the Olympics following his decision to give up a promising wrestling career after watching Greg Louganis on TV at the 84 Games. He has total confidence in his athletic ability.
I always knew I was going to make it. I mean, there was no doubt. I have had no doubts in my mind since even before I started. I didn't know what sport it was going to be, but because I've done so many, but I knew I was going to make the Olympic Games.
Mark earned his trip to Barcelona with an impressive performance at the trials, nailing down the win with his final and most difficult dive. That victory established Lenzi, at least temporarily, as America's top springboard diver. And the fact that it came at the expense of Ferguson made it doubly sweet for Lenzi. Mark still bristles at the notion that he performs in the shadow of the world champion.
I'm not in Kent's shadow. I've beaten Kent the past 2 years. I mean, Kent is a great diver, and he's going to be one of the favorites, but I am by no means in his shadow. I think he's in mine.